everyone. Today we will be covering how to create and modify materials using the materials palette in FormIt. For this we will use a couple primitive cubes to demonstrate. Let's begin by selecting the materials palette from the palette toolbar. Select the Create New Material button to get to the Material Editor dialog. Inside of the dialog we have 2D and 3D previews of the material. You can apply a color, which will take you to the color selection dialog, and this will paint your material a solid color or tint any texture image you load. You can load in image files for the texture, bump, and cutout maps. Inside of the properties, you can name the material and select the horizontal or vertical scale size by dimensions and lock them proportionally. You can adjust the visual qualities by adding transparency, reflection, and gloss. So let's make two materials utilizing the different options within the material editor. We can begin by adding a texture map. Click inside of the texture box to get your file explorer and select a JPEG or PNG. I'm using a brick image to demonstrate. You can optionally add a bump or normal map, which is a special image used to give your material a dimensional quality. Now let's name our material brick and adjust the horizontal and vertical scale to match the material size. Since these are brick courses, I can count them to determine the approximate height and width. I can unlock the proportions if I need my material to stretch more in either direction, but the original scales are determined by the proportion of your imported image, so unless you want to distort the image, leave them locked and update one of the scales. Now if you click and drag in the 3D preview box, you can rotate the preview cube to see your results. You can also scroll to zoom in or out. Let's press OK and paint this onto one of the primitive cubes to see the result. Now let's create a new material and make a chain link fence utilizing the cutout image. Let's load in a texture and then the cutout and see how the preview shows the cutout black areas are completely transparent. Let's add some reflection to this material since it is metal, and notice when we add gloss how the light travels around the edges more easily. Many of these settings will be specific to your preferences, so be sure to use the preview and test the material in your model with sun and shadows on. That's it for FormIt Create and Modify Materials in the Materials palette. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.